Because so often I see in today's modern life that people make a commitment to do something and then don't follow through and do it. And this is detrimental to our willpower. Yogananda said when you give your word to do something, that you should do everything in your power to accomplish that. So this goes to the little things in our life, like saying that you'll meet a friend for coffee. Make sure that you actually go do that. Or, you know, Swami Kriyananda was a great example of this. Whatever he said he would do it. And even, I think apparently one day when he was in Italy, he said that he was going to read the newspaper. And when he went into town, there were no newspapers available. They were already sold out. And he apparently drove like an hour and a half to the next village to buy a newspaper simply because he said he would. You know, what's the real purpose of the newspaper in that instance? It's not that he needed the news or else, but he had made the commitment of his willpower that he was going to do something. And the more you prove to yourself your ability, your own ability to meet your goals, to accomplish things, the more you begin to trust in the power of the infinite to flow through you, to the point that eventually when you give your word to do something, when you give your commitment to do it, you are already committing your energy to the achievement of that task, to the eventual point that actually Patanjali says when you practice this perfectly, you no longer even need to act. You say that you'll do something, you say that something is so, and it is so, because you've already committed the necessary energy to make it a reality. So I encourage you, just take a look at your commitments. Take a look at what you say you'll do versus what you actually do, and try and bring them closer into alignment. For example, if you say to yourself that you're going to practice the energization exercises every day, practice them every day. The more you can adhere to your word, the more power your word will have. Power to help others, power to help yourself. And coincidentally, I encourage you to make that commitment to yourself. Try practicing every day. Try practicing these simple exercises every day for a week. Just make that little commitment for 1 week and see what changes. See how your life might improve. And then if that week goes well, make it another week, or say a month, or a year, and see what can happen. So for now, let's make the commitment that we're going to energize front to back together. Let's pray. O Infinite Spirit, recharge my body with thy cosmic energy. Recharge my mind with thy concentration and determination. And recharge my soul and all souls with thy ever-new joy. O Eternal Spirit of youth in body and mind, abide within me forever, forever, forever. Om, Amen. And let's practice double breathing, palms touching. And left calf recharge. Tense up, relax, tense down. Again. And ankle rotation with will, energy, willingness, and switch sides. You know, one of the things Yogananda said to develop willpower is he said, make yourself little goals that are easily achieved and achieve them. And then slowly take ankle rotation, switch directions. And let's do left calf and forearm together. Relax, thigh and upper arm. Alternate, lower and upper. One more time. And switch sides, right calf and forearm, upper thigh and arm. Switch. And he said, over time, choose bigger and bigger goals that require greater and greater energy. But if you consistently succeed at the goals you place before yourself, you will gain willpower. You will gain confidence in your ability to achieve. So if it's just, you know, you could tell yourself, both calves and forearms, today I will practice the energization exercises, and do it. That's one day. It's a one-day commitment, one time. And then the next day, maybe you could try 2 days in a row, and three. And eventually you'll find that you're capable of incredible things. Even simply saying that you're committing to practicing the energization exercise as well. Let's do left bottom and left side of chest. Right, left, right, left, right, left lower back, right. Even just saying that you're going to do these exercises well now is an act of will. And the more consciously, consistently, and willingly you can do that, the greater your will become over time. And the sense of the left middle back, relax, right? Left and right. Left and right. Left upper back, relax, right? Left, right. Left, right. Hands on your shoulders and rotate with tension. Switch directions. Tense the center of the throat. Again. One last time, and left side of the neck, relax, right? Left and right. Drop the chin, tense the back of the neck. Twice more. Neck rotations with tension, switch directions. And no tension rotations. Switch directions. And spinal recharge with energy. Control the spine. Don't just whip it around. Be in control of the whole length of your spine through every part of this movement. And relax and feel. Hands on your hips. Rotate the spine through the pelvic bowl. Really feel the spine here. We're so unaware of our spines most of the time. But awareness of your spine is really one of the keys to success in any athletic endeavor. And being in your energetic spine is the key to success in so much of our spiritual endeavors. And now spinal stretching up and to the left, relax, and to the right, relax, left and right, again. And spinal adjustment, working one vertebrae up at a time, pressing in and up. And now upper spinal recharge. And skull tapping. And let's massage the scalp. I'm taking a slightly wider stance so my head fits into the frame. You don't have to stand this way. Stand in whatever comfortable position works for you. And at the base of the skull, let's with the first three fingers, press in and rotate. Switch directions and tense up. Again, three times in each direction with the fingers. Stop and press up. One more time. Clasp the fingers overhead. Tense the left biceps. Relax, right. Relax, left. Relax, right. Left and right. Tense the whole body with a double breath. Tense and relax the left foot. Right. Left calf. Right. Left thigh, right, left hip and bottom, right, lower abdomen, upper stomach, left forearm, right, left upper arm, right, left side of chest, right, left neck, right, throat, back of the neck. Now let's tense and relax. Left foot, right, left calf, right, left thigh, right, left bottom, right, lower stomach, upper stomach, left forearm, right, left arm, right, left chest, right, left neck, right, throat, back of the neck, tense the whole body. And relax just the neck. Now the right chest, left, right arm, left, right forearm, left stomach, abdomen, right glute, left, right thigh, left, right calf, left, right foot, left. Drop the chin and tense the whole body. Weight pulling to the front. Double breathing, elbows touching. Weight pulling to the sides. Tense in, relax, tense out. Shoulder rotations. Low, medium, high, relax, and feel. Switch. Low, medium, high, relax, and feel. Weight pulling to the front. Finger recharge. Out to the sides. In front of the body, overhead, relax. Four-part army charge, tense out, relax, tense in, relax, tense forward, relax, tense back, relax, tense overhead, relax down. Inhale, exhale, double in, double out. Inhale, exhale, double in, double out. One more time. Left army charge, right. With a wider stance, left arm up and over, relax down, right? March in place. And now let's run in place and let's see how high we can get our heads to pop out of the screens. Relax and feel. Let's do the fencing exercise. Large arm rotations, tense up, relax down. Switch. Stomach recharge. Pump the stomach. And stomach churning. Double breathing, palms touching. Left ankle recharge, or excuse me, left calf. Tense up, relax, tense down. And ankle rotation, switch directions. Right calf. Ankle rotation. Good. Hands on your hips. Rotate the leg. Switch directions. Right side. Switch directions. Double breathing, palms in front of the body. No tension. Close the eyes and feel. Awareness precedes control. We're trying to develop awareness of the energy in our body, in our minds, in our souls, all around us, so we can learn to control our own energy, control our destiny, control our feelings, and uplift them and offer them up to spirit. Find a deep sense of relaxation here. The deeper you can relax, the more acutely you will become aware of the subtle energy in the body. Bring the hands together in front of the heart and silently offer a wordless prayer or a worded prayer of gratitude in the language of your own heart for this infinite supply of energy. The ability to strengthen our willpower until we unite it with the infinite willpower. Om peace. Amen. Thank you, friends, for joining me. This week I encourage you to be determined to succeed in what you set out to do, whatever it is. Try to take things till their completion, and eventually you will be able to find that infinite source of all willpower, all willingness. Thank you, friends.